In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to use the Tektronix TDS 210 two-channel digital real-time oscilloscope. The purpose of an oscilloscope is to give a visual representation of electronic signals that exist in our circuits. This will help us to understand how electric signals behave and often allows us to diagnose problems within a circuit. If you watched the video on the function generator, you saw that the oscilloscope displays the output waveforms from the function generator. During that video, I did make some changes to the oscilloscope while making the video so that we could see the waves more clearly. So now I will go over how to make those changes as we go on the oscilloscope. To begin, let's go over the front panel display of the oscilloscope. The most prominent feature of the front panel of the oscilloscope is the screen on which the waveforms are displayed. The vertical axis displays how the waveform changes in amplitude or voltage. The horizontal axis displays how the waveform changes in time. Looking closely at the screen, we see it is divided up into a grid. Each of the subdivisions of the grid is called a division. What each of those divisions represents is shown on the bottom of the screen. We see that for channel 1, each division here represents 100 millivolts, and for channel 2, each division represents 1 volt. So for channel 1, from the top of the wave to the bottom of the wave is about 2 divisions. Since it is 100 millivolts per division, that means that this wave is 200 millivolts peak to peak. For channel 2, each division represents 1 volt. From the top of the wave to the bottom of the wave, there are about 3.4 divisions at 1 volt per division. This gives us a value of 3.4 volts peak to peak for the waveform. The horizontal axis is also divided by subdivisions. In this case, the divisions for each of the channels remain the same, and it is 500 microseconds per division. If we look at the square waves, and we looked at the starting voltage of 2 successive waves, there are 2 divisions at 500 microseconds per division, which results in a time of 1 millisecond. If we remember, the relationship between period and frequency is an inverse relationship. We notice this corresponds to a frequency of 1 kilohertz, which is 1 divided by 1 millisecond. Knowing the relationship between the period of a wave and its frequency is very important for being able to display a wave's different frequencies on an oscilloscope, as we will see later. Channel 1 is controlled by these 3 controls. Channel 2 is controlled by these controls. We can adjust the position of the wave on the screen, which refers to the point indicated by the numbers 1 and 2 on the left-hand side of the screen. For each of these waves, this is the point that is considered as 0 volts. The volts represented by each division is controlled by these 2 knobs. The left-hand knob controls channel 1 and the right-hand knob controls channel 2. The volts per division can be set independently for each channel. The third set of controls adjusts the horizontal axis or the time axis. We can adjust the time equals 0 point and per seconds per division to look at different frequency signals. The right-hand set of controls refers to the trigger. Since we are looking at time-varying signals, we need to tell the oscilloscope at what voltage level it needs to start looking for a signal. If we do not set a trigger level, the waveforms will roll across the screen and we will not be able to see a stable waveform. The trigger level, or the voltage level at which it starts to look for the waveform, is indicated on the right-hand side of the screen. On the far right of the screen, we see there is a menu of options. The button just to the right of each of these is the input for that option. So this button corresponds to this menu item, this button corresponds to this one, and so forth. Up at the top, we have a group of buttons called menu buttons. These correspond to some functionality of the oscilloscope that I will show you later. Other buttons on the front panel include the hard copy button. By default, this button will send an image of whatever is displayed on the screen via RS-232 protocol. In our laboratory, this output is connected to the computer on the lab bench, and there's a program on the computer called WinTech32, which will receive the image and allow you to save the image to the computer. The run-stop button controls whether the oscilloscope is actively grabbing signals or if it is just holding on to the signal that it had when the button was pressed. If the run-stop button is pressed so that the oscilloscope is in the stop mode, the oscilloscope will display whatever was on the screen when the button was pressed. The last button on the front panel that I will talk about is the auto-set button. This button is only necessary when we have no idea what to expect. Since we understand the relationship between period and frequency, and we have at least a basic idea of what our circuit is doing, we should always know what settings to manually put onto the oscilloscope so that we should never use this button. This button is not for electrical engineering students. Lastly, the power button for the oscilloscope is on the top left-hand side of the oscilloscope.
All right, a couple things have occurred since I started making this video. First and most significantly, a tornado hit the campus, including the building in which I work. It wasn't destroyed, but because of the damage, it will be at least a couple months before I can get back into the building. This means I have to make some adjustments to my filming and editing techniques. Second, I realized that the original video was too long as I planned it, even after editing out significant portions. So I am instead breaking the video into three parts. The first is this one, which is an overview of the oscilloscope. The second will go over making measurements. The third will go over transferring data to the computer. That's all for today. Go out and make it a great one.